So we're now on to the part of council called, we call council-initiated discussion. Up until now, we've been force-feeding you information that we think will be of interest to you and good for you, and this is your chance to push back on us and tell us you've waited until 4:35 for us to give you the floor. We've used this time to solicit ideas, things that you want to draw to our attention, maybe issues that we're not paying enough attention to, or topics that you might want to hear the Institute report back to.
Please pardon the interruption. Your conference contains less than 3 participants at this time.
Hang up.
If you would like to continue, press star 1 now, or the conference will be terminated.
Please terminate the conference. So Eric's actually going to run this. The floor is open.
Joe.
Eric, something's been nagging at me all afternoon that Jill pointed out. And although I'm not in this field, I heard a lot today about big data and bioinformatics and how we're going to have to train all these people. Yet I saw that, given the variance, a little slight dip in the bioinformatics support or funding. And I wonder if that in part isn't due to what you pointed out on your slide was these open positions, 2 open positions, in fact, for staff to really put forward the initiatives. Maybe in that, is that part of the potential dip?
Jeff, you may want to move closer to a microphone because I'm going to ask you to make a comment. You just heard. By the way, I do want to point out that analyses like the ones you're referring to, they have error bars around them because a lot of it is a function of how we're coding, you know, grants, parts of our portfolio and all that. So, you know, I'll look to other senior leadership here to weigh in. I don't think there's any systematic decline in our investment. And I mean, I'm not claiming it's on the uptick. I think it's pretty steady state. But as I'm going to ask Jeff to comment in a minute, I mean, there have been issues around our ability of just being able to tread water in that area with enough program director folks working on stuff. And I'll also point out that, to be fair, that the last, it's almost the better part of the last year, we have been sucked in. I mean, we, starting with me, Mark Geyer, and then about 3 or 4 of our bioinformatics program directors have really been pulled into this BD2K initiative at the NIH level to stand it up. And so even though with none of the spare time that anybody had, that almost became, especially over the summer, I can tell you, just last summer, just huge amounts of work. So I think there's a lot of, and those aren't excuses, but I actually don't think it's a real decline, but it's also not a growth area. It hasn't been, even though we need it to be. It's one of the reasons why we're advertising 2 positions. But Jeff,
so Joey, you're absolutely right, and we have a bandwidth problem. And Terry alluded to it in terms of the genomic medicine program, and the genomic sciences program. I would posit has a more one. We're running a lot of very large programs, complicated programs. The people who have the best ability to contribute to the development of the next program on, and some of these got kicked to FY15 because we couldn't finish them in FY13 or FY14.
It may be a very difficult
bandwidth problem, right?
Be difficult hires. Yes. Oh, yeah. And that's why we need your help. Other comments, thoughts, things you want to see it where we in May, September council topics, September or next February. Well, we've either satisfied them or exhausted them or both. Yeah, Jill.
I just want to emphasize the informatics portfolio strategy comment that I made earlier this morning as a possible. Do I have to go through the whole thing again?
No.
as a possible topic for either September or
yeah.
February.
No. Okay. No, we've got it.
Yeah.
We will follow up. We want to make sure we have all the right information.
No,
as
no,
far
no
as
I
to
understand.
Make it
I just think there is a little bit of urgency because of what else is going on at NIH.
Okay. Nothing else? Okay. Back to you, Rudy.
All right. So a couple more things to do before we close out the open session. It's my duty to draw to your attention A couple of things that you can find in the electronic council book. The first is a quarterly report. Sorry, wrong page. I'll go to the document itself. There's a report on administrative actions, again found in the electronic council book. I think in this case there are three supplements that were made to NHGRI grants. The next is the funding actions from the most recent council. That would refer back to what we talked about in February, what we reviewed, what you approved in February. You can see the list of awards that have been made there. And the last is the expedited council concurrence report. The three members there are Howard, Amy, and who's my third person on there? Jim. Okay. These are largely SBIR and STTR applications that were reviewed this round. The three of them looked them over and reviewed them, gave feedback to the Institute. It allows the Institute to start on a rapid pace to make awards sooner than later. And again, in that report, you'll see the list of awards that we propose to make. Okay. The last thing is the reading of the conflict of interest. And Monica, do you want to bring Comfort in? Okay, she's ready to go.
Presentations from today's the open session. There are a lot of presentations that we don't have available yet.
So the presentations are being sent to me right now. I've gotten a couple of them. We will post them on the website. You can go to the agenda and they'll be clickable there. Okay. All right. So at your desk in the folders or at your places at the folders, there should be a copy of the conflict of interest form. We'll ask you to pull it out and sign it. And Comfort will come around and collect it from you. But I'm going to read the chant. This will certify that in the review of applications conducted by the National Advisory Council for Human Genome Research on February 11 and 12, 2013, I absented myself and did not participate in the discussion of, nor vote on, any application in which I, or to my knowledge, my spouse, child, or close professional associate has a financial interest, nor on any application from an organization or institution where I am an employee, consultant, officer, director, or trustee, or am negotiating for employment, or otherwise have a financial interest. In council actions in which we voted on a block of applications without discussing any individual one, the so-called on-block actions, my vote did not apply to any application from any institution fulfilling the criteria in the preceding paragraph. So say we all. So please sign that form, and unless I've missed something, I think we're done with the open session. And do you want to gavel us into a transition to
the decide what time we're going to reconvene? We will take a break until, why don't we say right till 5 o'clock?
How about 5 till 5? I think we can clear the room by then.
Okay. All right, so we will close the open session, and let's plan just take a break now for about 10 minutes. And we will reconvene at 5 minutes to 5. And we'll probably go about, an hour or so. Well, isn't that about our plan?
I hope closer to 45 minutes, but it all depends on how talkative you are.
Okay.